Obviously, you're such a big chess streamer these days, very popular. Can you tell us a little bit about the early days of streaming and how you got into it?
So I've played competitive chess my whole life, and I have always thought that that was the only really thing that you could do with chess. I thought, okay, either you compete or maybe you're a chess trainer, but that's it. I didn't really think about anything else because when I was a little kid, I always dreamed of being a YouTuber. I thought that talking was really fun, and I have a lot of really old videos of me showing magazines and talking about my iPhone case collection and blah, blah. And I thought that the problem was that the only thing that I was good at was chess, which is something in my mind then was not for the internet. So I just thought, okay, I guess I'll never be a YouTuber. I'll have to do something else because I'm only good at chess. But then in 2020, I was asked, well, late 2019, if I wanted to commentate my first chess tournament, which was the Rolton Cup. And I had never done chess commentary before. And to be honest, my chess had been going pretty bad the few months before that. So I thought, okay, I'll take a break from competing. I'll do something else. And so I commentated the chess tournament. And then after that, I realized that, all right, we can talk about chess. Okay, I know what chess commentary is, but it was first when chess.com contacted me and asked me if I wanted to commentate the Women's World Chess Championship that I really started getting into the internet world. And I remember that very clearly because they said, Anna, the Women's World Chess Championship is starting in 2 days. It's going to be at 4:30 a.m. your time every single day. Do you want to commentate it? And I was going to high school then, so I had class at 9.
Wow.
So I remember that I thought, okay, this is a must yes situation. If I say no, I know this will close down future opportunities. I have to say yes, but I really don't want to do this right now. This is going to be painful for the next 2 weeks. But I did it, and it was a lot of fun, and I'm really happy that I did it. And it was after that that I was introduced to Twitch, and people started saying that I should open up a Twitch channel. And I just thought, well, if I'm ever going to do this, it's now. Now is the time where I've gotten this kind of recognition. So I opened up a Twitch channel then in January 2020, and I started just streaming when I was playing chess and when I was talking. And a few months later, the pandemic hit Europe. So my school closed down, and I just had a lot of extra free time all of a sudden. And so I just spent more time streaming, and I truly only saw it as a hobby then. I just thought that it was fun to play Blitz and Bullet and talk about chess. I thought it was great. But I think the love for content creation kind of evolved from there. That was very much just the beginning.
Wow. And what do you think has been the key to your success as a streamer and content creator?
Honestly, that I'm very much myself and I don't take myself too seriously. I think that it's very important when you do things to be authentic to yourself. And I think that it's very easy to see if someone is being authentic or not. And I think that in a world where we're trying all the time to be so perfect, we're trying to put out perfect YouTube videos, we're trying to put out the absolute perfect version of ourselves, we kind of lose the authentic part of ourselves. And I think that I really try to not do that, and I hope that people can get the feeling of that, and that is why I like to upload. It doesn't matter if I lose, if I win, if whatever. I like to upload real moments of time, kind of like when I uploaded when we were in your party, in your house party.
Yeah, yeah.
And people were singing Wonderwall.
You crushed me in Odin. Well, remind us.
I didn't upload that part. I uploaded when I lost to David Howell.
Ah, okay. Yeah, yeah. You were winning, right?
I was.
At least one of the games.
Yeah. At one point, yeah.
At one point. I should upload the other game when I beat you. Thank you for reminding everyone.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
But I just like showing different moments in time. And yeah, I think that in its core is probably one of the main reasons. And then I think that the content in itself, there's not really that many people that travel around the world and play over-the-board chess games and strike conversations with strangers. So I think the content as well, but I think it's the other thing at its core.
But what a house party. So credit to you, Odin, and your parents. I mean, we were having some Blitz games, some karaoke in the background. You were singing a lot.
Yeah, yeah. try to sing at least.
It was great. No, it was a full-on concert. I loved it. I've never felt so good playing chess.
Ah, that's
cool. Want that soundtrack in my background every time I play chess. It was amazing
to
hear Wonderwall.
That's our traveling band of chess players.
Bring the guitarist as well. The guy that was there, he needs to join.
Yeah.
I don't know where he is.
And then one of the documentary... From one of the
coworkers, he started playing the piano. So he had a band going on.
I love that band. Yeah, no, it was beautiful. Please do more house parties like that. Chess house parties are the best thing possible. And people were jealous in the comments.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They said, wow, this is what a real house party looks like. Not the other kinds. Not with dancing. No, with playing chess.
Fantastic. And... we're watching, you know, different chess streamers, content creators out there. And obviously, Hikaru Nakamura is a big chess streamer. And I follow him on Twitter. And he often posts his schedule, you know, for the week. And it seems very, it's a lot of hard work. And it's a grind at times. What are your thoughts on that? And how kind of demanding or difficult can it be to be a professional streamer and content creator?
I think it's a really tricky question because I think that it's a lot of hard work. It's definitely a lot of hard work. It's a full-time job for sure. But I think that everyone is doing it in a different way. So Hikaru, for instance, he focuses a lot on streaming. So he spends a lot of time streaming and then he posts a lot of the parts from his streams on YouTube. He also does recaps and he competes on the highest level of chess. So, I mean, I don't know where he has any free time because he's doing things all the time. But I think it's very different for everyone. And I think it's a little bit about what your goals are. I used to definitely stream a lot more in the past. I used to really put in the hours. Now I'm trying to work a little bit more smartly and less hardly. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, makes sense.
For me personally right now, it's a lot of traveling. I travel a lot. And when I travel, I'm definitely filming or recording between 8 and 10 hours a day.
Wow, so that's a lot.
It's a lot. And very little of it comes out to YouTube or to social media. So it's a lot of work that people do not see. But then when I'm home, then maybe I'm doing a little bit less and I'm maybe focusing on studying chess or on streaming a bit more or on recording videos at home. But I think the best part about being a content creator is that you're very free and you can choose exactly what you want to do. And if you want to go to Paris to play chess in front of the Eiffel Tower, you can. Or if you want to do, you're so free to do any creative idea that you have. And so there's no amount of hours that you have to put in, but I think you just have to be smart about what you do.
And is it like tough to come up with funny and interesting ideas, like to present to your fans? Or are you more the type of streamer, content creator that does things on the go if you're traveling and stuff like that?
So I think a lot of things that I come up with are on the go. I definitely just like being in front of people and playing chess and seeing what angles these things take. Because for me, it's very important that in my content, it comes off as authentic. So it's hard for me unless I have like, my mom is going to prank these people. Nobody knows she's a grandmaster. Unless I have this kind of general idea, I do prefer that I see what actually happens. And then I frame the video from what happened. But I think the hardest part is not when you get to that point. I think the hardest part is in the beginning when you're trying to find your voice. What is your initial thing? When I started streaming, I had no idea, what am I contributing? What am I doing? Am I contributing by just being funny and just streaming online chess? Am I contributing? What is my contribution to the chess world? How can I stand out from everyone else? Am I contributing just by having 2 grandmaster parents? What is actually what I can bring in? And I think that question is the hardest question to answer as a content creator. I think the moment you find what it is that you provide, all the ideas within that become a lot easier. But it took me years to actually understand what it is that I'm doing. Mm. So that was very difficult. But now that I know that I'm the girl that travels around the world and plays chess and goes to random places and meets people, it becomes a lot easier to do things within that. Mm. But I didn't know that that was what I was going to be when I started.
It's really nice to hear your perspective on streaming. And I think that you mentioned earlier that when you were a child, you traveled a lot and your parents both played chess, and chess was sort of life. And basically what you're doing is you're just documenting a really special life. So you found your thing, and I think that's, yeah, that's something that will always be interesting to people because it's so special, as you said.
Yeah, it's crazy in a way that I'm able to make a living out of chess. That was always my dream when I was younger. I wanted to become a professional chess player, apart from a YouTuber and everything else that I wanted to be, but that was one of my goals. I wanted to become a professional chess player and make a living out of chess. And now I am, but in a very different way. So yeah, there's still so many things that I want to do, and there's so many more things I want to document, but I think it's fun that the world gets to see how amazing the chess world is, because it's truly an amazing community and an amazing world, and I'm just happy I can take people on that ride.